Yo, 5, 4, 3 to the motherfucking one. I come through with a bullet and a gun. She said she really want some. Bust it on her tummy, then she come with big son. Let it run. Let it run. What it do, what it do?
Yo, back on Thirsty Thursday, but we're gonna call this Thanksgiving Thursday because,
Thanksgiving Thursday.
We're here in the pit on a Thursday, and I know you're like, yo, why the hell ain't anybody supposed to be having Thanksgiving? Don't worry about it. It's gonna be early enough or late enough for you and me and everybody else to get their fat asses something to eat and chill and, sit back and get a little bit from your fellas. You know, we still gonna keep it consistent, still gonna go with the toughest topics.
And you ladies too, and you ladies too.
And, and we're gonna stick to the toughest topics. Some of them might be silly, some of them might be real, some of them might be too real, but whatever, we're gonna let you know we keep it real. Definitely on Fuck Your Opinion Podcast on Fridays, Thirsty Thursdays, which I say again is Thanksgiving Thursday.
Again, and Thanksgiving
Thursday.
Happy Thanksgiving.
And the loved ones and family and everybody on Facebook that tune in and everybody that's tuning in.
Man, I gotta show my first shape up. I can't have it.
Oh, thanks.
You know what I'm saying? You the mediator anyway, you know.
Yeah. And don't forget, if you tune in on a day like today, we still take phone calls. You know, you still can hit us up, you know, live in the studio, you know, express your opinion, you know, let us know, whatever, how you
feel.
Might
be a little difficult today, but.
I mean, you know, I just always want to put that out there. The phone number is, the lines are open. What's the number again?
I forgot.
Oh, yeah, the number. 240.
Right. 240.
Yeah.
We're gonna, just 240.
Yeah, I can't even get the number. It's on my other, it's on my camera.
Y'all know, look, watch the other show and get the goddamn number.
That's a good idea.
You gotta watch the show before.
Stay tuned and always tune in. Fucking Mike is going for much. Anyway, here on Thanksgiving Thursday,
Thanksgiving Thursday.
We still gonna talk about the thirst. Don't have to be the thirst and fame, always in fortune, but there's always some wild shit going on. So, we dedicate our Thirsty Thursdays and sometimes Taco Tuesdays to shit that we can't really touch on. Fuck Your Opinion Fridays. But still, fuck your opinion. Our first topic is, it's a new birth control method. It's been in the news. It's been in, I'm sure, magazines. Probably not parenting magazines or what's the shit that they show? What's the place you go, child, come on, help me out here, fella.
For what?
You know, when you have go to child, when you want to become a fucking
men's
man.
Health. It's a lot of
the clinics,
clinic magazine.
Shit, I'm about to say abortion clinic.
Whoa!
I mean, you won't see this. This might be an abortion clinic.
Yeah, hey, I'm saying what you said.
That's what I'm saying. You know, childhood parenting. You know, whatever the fuck. Sorry. Sometimes I black out. Sometimes I blank out. But I'm always cashing in. Anyway, Planned Parenthood. See, sometimes it gotta come back to me. So, you know, I'm at Toucan Dan sometimes. You know, I don't like to get too much into it, but I do follow my nose for the trees that grow. So sometimes I have black spots. But anyway, fucking Planned Parenthood may have this. Okay, so it's a contraceptive for men. It's a birth control that lasts approximately 13 years.
13 years, goddamn!
You can knock off a lot of steam in 13 years.
That's
too fucking long,
man. It's too long. You'll miss out on a whole lifetime.
You fucking running.
You missing out on
chick. Chick would be like, man, I want a baby, and then you just like, yeah.
That baby, I got 8 more years to go. You got to get to know me for 8 more years.
Well, I mean, what the fuck you gonna tell a woman who'd be like, you know, hey?
So when do you get? So let me ask you a question: if this, and this is hypothetically thinking because of the age, what if you have a child? Say your son's like 14, 15. Would you recommend some shit like that? Because, I mean, in 13 years, he'd be 28. He'd be going into his 30s. That'd be a perfect time for him to really...
I don't recommend that shit at all.
No, I mean, but who are you to play God with somebody else's life?
I mean, you just...
I'm trying to get a little shot. I'm trying to get Donald's attention. At 13 years old...
Say 15.
Even 15. 13 would be better because... He's under your roof for more years, so, I mean, you kind of have...
I mean, shit, 13, you got to at least shit, 5, 6 nowadays, maybe 7 more years. But motherfucker, I mean, you know, you.
No, never... I think this birth control that they're talking about, where they give you the shot. Where's the shot at? Your ass, your shoulder? Do it matter?
I think it's in the testicles.
In what?
It's in the testicles.
In the ball sack.
In the ball sack. It says they had test subjects. One test subject was quoted saying, "When I think about this whole concept of contraception that you have to inject, it's too graphic. Our testicles are like family jewels, so I have to resort to using any kind of contraceptive. I'd rather for appeal." So, yeah, they take a syringe and they shoot you in your nuts. And for 13 years, I mean, you be putting on the green, but you ain't going to get no hole in one.
You just shooting blanks like a mug.
Bang, 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 bang. In the memory of Pop. Bang, 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 bang.
I mean, you know, if you're at the age where you already have kids or and you don't want any more, I mean, 13 years is...
I mean, I do agree with you guys. Like, if you 30 and you get that shot, you got to wait till you 43.
43.
That's what I'm saying. It's good. I mean, if you're younger, it's good to put it into use when at a time where you don't want your son to be 19, 20, 22 years old.
But I wouldn't get it to no child, though, man, because that probably could fuck some shit up. Probably could fuck some shit up.
If you produce sperm, you saying it might stun his growth or something. He might have.
I'm just saying, shit. That might be a problem. I'm talking about, like, it might fuck them up in the future from having kids. You know what I'm saying? It might be some.
I mean, if that shit is that bad, if you're waiting 13 years to find out you can't have any more kids, you basically fucked up. I mean, it says, listen, 303 people were candidates for this experiment. 97.3% was the success rate with no side effects.
Yeah, but you don't hit that 100. I mean, even though that's close enough. 100. Yeah, I'm just saying, even though they ain't close enough.
Now, I tell you what, I would like to be one of them niggas that, if you can shoot me in my nuts and I can't produce kids, that shit work, because I'm a fertile motherfucker. This nigga Don is too. If me and this nigga can get shot down nut, you should pay us. If you're willing to pay me, I will do it.
They already got. You missed the test subject part when it was 303. I mean, certain.
You give me a couple hundred thousand, goddamn. You can shoot me in my nuts.
Yeah, I'm gonna see. So you saying you'd be the spokesperson for the?
I would be the spokesperson for the
ball juice. Whatever.
But I mean, I mean, to be honest, as far as the subject goes, I have a couple thoughts in my head, man, and none of them are really good thoughts about getting shot in your ball sack and then not being able to have children for 13 years. Personally, I love children. I have.
That's a long ass.
That's a long time, man, to not be able to.
I see
kids.
5 years, man. You could
13. Because no, you know, the women have the
IUD.
The IUD is what, a year?
No, this shit like. 5 years?
3 years?
I've known them to be 5 and 10 years.
Yeah, you know.
You can do the 5 year, you can do the 10 year one. Yeah. 13 is just like an awkward ass number, man. Like, that shit is a fucking.
I mean, you know, some people don't like kids. Some people never want kids. I know my homeboy, he don't never want a kid.
Yeah, it's people that don't. I mean, you know.
Yeah, but I mean, yeah, you. But see, I think.
But I wouldn't get that shit to no kid, though. I just don't think.
I mean, that's what I mean, because, like,
I just think, because you just don't know the side effects. You might fuck them up.
I mean, but if there's no side effects,
let's leave out on this, okay? Often in today's society, throughout life, past, we find ourselves playing God. I feel like this is kind of on the edge of playing God, because there will be some parents, like you say, who will say, well, you know, we'll give little Zaire and little Keisha, Keisha can't get shot in the balls, but Johnny, Stevie, and Zaire can get shot in the balls, and they can't have kids for 13 years. Well, then I think you're getting on the line of playing God, because how do you know if your kids don't want children at 19, 20 years old? Who the fuck want to be old-ass parents?
But at the same time, they could prevent a lot of childhood pregnancy.
That they could, but see, that right there, bro, is part of,
to me, is a sound. I mean, you don't know if that's going to fuck them up in the future. That's where my thing would be.
What's supposed to happen is supposed to happen.
You can't even mention God, because people...
And you know how many bastards out here that are amazing people?
Yeah, because but listen, what I'm saying.
One night stand.
But what I'm saying, that point is not the purpose of God.
I'm a one night stand baby.
I mean, a lot of people are.
I'm just kidding. I probably was more.
But I'm saying this on another note, it still can prevent a lot of things from happening.
Hey, man. I decided
the time is what.
Yeah, 13 years is a long time.
If you can do 5 years, if it's some shit where it's five to where you can.
13 fucking years.
I wouldn't give nobody no 13
years. And then they got to shoot you with a needle in your
balls. Yeah, I wouldn't give nobody no 13 years.
Yeah, they got to shoot you in the balls.
God damn.
I mean, you get anesthesia, though. I mean, listen, it's a process when you get an anesthesia. Then they don't just lie. Because, I mean, you got to be a tough motherfucker to sit and watch somebody put a needle in your testicle. Mm. That is, you got to be strong in the gut to even watch that without doing one of these. Like, if they get the needle too close, you can't, I can't. Just the human reaction of a man has got to be a constant, I mean, whatever.
I'm ready to grab my nuts right now. Just talking about it. Like, that's some horrible shit.
Yeah, I mean, but I mean, hey, you know, listen. This is what happens when, you know, hey, this is the game. This is the new millennium. We were just talking about the fucking people getting suspended in animation and all that shit. Science is definitely, I mean, people may feel like it's going too far. They may feel like it's doing too much. But as long as there's someone out there looking
for
something,
you'll be fucked up. You get that shot. You get a shot in your balls, right? You break up with your girl or you meet this badass shawty. And, I mean, she is all the way across the board, dime piece. Good job, good body, personality, no kids. And then in a year and a half, 2 years, she'd be like, yeah, baby, you know, I would really like to have kids right now while I'm, you know, in my prime. And you say, well, damn, baby, I can't have kids for another 11 years.
I can't have kids till I'm 28.
You know what she going to say? Jody can.
Well, hey, Jody gonna have that problem on his hands by the time you're 28.
Jody can. Where Jody at? Call that nigga Step Up. Where's Step at? Oh.
28, I mean, like I said, if it's
someone in the fucking opinion, it looks Step Up.
If it's a
you down?
It's a possibility.
If you was able to get that to your son, would you do that?
I mean, hey, if it was safe and he was at the age of 13, 14, yeah. Man, I would.
That nigga be mad and shit.
I mean, he would be mad because by the time he's 26, 27 years old, he can still have children.
That nigga get old and shit because, yeah, remember, he's going to have old-ass babies.
No, listen, if you're 26 years old, then you still are considered a young man, and you have a lot more under your belt to me where you better than being a 19-year-old father. Give me a 26-year-old father over a 19-year-old father most of the time. But anyway, whatever this company, pharmaceutical company that's coming up with this, I'm trying to find it, but it's kind of hard to find out the actual pharmaceutical.
Man, you shoot niggas in their nuts. Fuck your opinion.
Listen, no, but I mean, listen,
terrible
man,
motherfuckers.
I'm with Don. I'm with Gotti on this one. Fuck, shorten your time. Figure something out with the time frame. 13 years is too goddamn
years.
Long.
God
give
damn.
Them five, four.
Niggas don't even live that long.
Give
nowadays.
A nigga 4 years, three. Can a three? Is three decent?
3 years is good, man.
3 is decent.
Yeah,
that's from 16 to 19.
Have no motherfucking. No, who the fuck would have kids at 37? 35,
I mean, yeah, 36. Yeah, whatever the fuck. If I wish I could find the name of this fuck. But anyway, this is an information platform.
Excuse me.
It's testicular shots for men to stop them from having children for 13 years. I don't truly agree with that shit on that principle of what Don says, man. Fuck with your time. Shorten it up and figure that shit out. Let's move on. Let's see what I got next. Oh, well, since we know it's Thanksgiving, what's the greatest thing that follow turkey and gravy and mashed potatoes and macaroni and cheese and all that lovely shit that we like to call food? Pies and sweet potatoes and fried chicken and potato salad. Devil eggs. Anyway, I like to get into it, but you know, Thanksgiving is just, you know, for black people, it's just ultimate potluck. But anyway, one best thing about having a great day like today, Friday.
Football?
You know, football. That's all today.
Food and football is the greatest thing Thanksgiving could ever give.
Yeah. And I ain't going to bring up today's matchup on the game because fuck them. But anyway.
Why not? You got the colors on.
No.
Detroit, Chicago, right?
Yeah, and Dallas. And,
Dallas Buffalo. And Buffalo.
Today, facing off. Buffalo, bust their ass. I mean, we get a couple of Thanksgiving, but we don't get too much of shit. But anyway, Rodgers, I feel your pain. You took an ass whooping. I took a beating on social media. You took a beating on the field. We are brothers in arms. Let's get back together. And we got the Giants coming up on Sunday.
So y'all lose the Giants. Y'all done.
We're going to bust some ass. But anyway.
I told you that Dwayne Haskins is going to get him one.
Black Friday is the best thing that has happened to today. One of
the most treacherous two words in the
world. Black Friday is the best thing that happened to Thanksgiving because it gives us a reason to enjoy these bountiful foods. And then once we finish and we stuff this fucking can't move, we get up and try to kill each other at Walmart for flat screen TVs.
Yeah, I've never been shopping on Black Friday.
Me neither.
I briefly went. That shit crazy.
Was it more like an experiment?
I just wanted to check it out, man.
Some people go.
I got the fuck up out of there though. But then I found out you can go to other places and get the deals too.
You can order online and get the deals.
No, I'm talking about when I went. It's been a few years, but I was able to go to Radio Shack. The last time I went to Radio Shack. That's a
shout out to Radio Shack. You're out of there.
Yeah.
Damn, Radio Shack couldn't keep... Because Radio Shack starts selling white
ass shit. Best Buy.
Just like remote control, huh? Best Buy is fuck Radio Shack.
You remember the Radio Shack commercials? They had some dope-ass commercials.
Yeah, with the Santa Claus and the guy. And the snowman.
Best Buy, dog.
Radio Shack used to be the shit till they just start selling remote control cars.
They used to have the shit you need. Like, the shit you would make up, they would have.
Now, you know what fucked up Radio Shack? Circuit City.
Best Buy fucked up all them niggas.
Walmart, Best Buy ain't getting hit hard like it used to. I mean, it's still.
Well, nah, niggas is ordering everything on. Niggas don't go shopping no more, dog. Niggas ordering Amazon,
but that one day shipping, man.
Who the fuck?
Game changer.
You know what? Now it's actually was on a news broadcast where Amazon changed the game so bad, even UPS and the United Postal Service said they came up to doing one night.
Listen, Amazon selling pussy.
Good pussy.
You can one day priority pussy.
Good pussy.
He dropped it at my house last week.
Good pussy.
Poor pussy. Spanish pussy.
UPS.
Black pussy. White pussy.
What can Brown do for you?
Indian pussy.
Brown can't bring no
pussy. Amazon pussy.
UPS. You step your game up.
Hey, step your game up.
What can Brown do for you?
Brown
can't
bring no pussy.
All right,
I'm just kidding also.
Speaking of.
Ladies.
Bringing the pussy.
Mm-hmm.
And Black Friday.
Black Friday.
Pornhub.
Uh-oh.
We are all adults here.
I've never heard of Pornhub. What is that?
Huh?
What is Pornhub?
It is a hub. Oh, listen, hear that? That's just porn train pulling up.
Porn train?
It could be similar, train going through the whole
four. Are we talking about porn on Thanksgiving?
We all got to be thankful for something.
Amen. Porn every day, man.
There we go. I'm a married man. I think porn saved my marriage on many nights.
I can't really do porn unless I'm real desperate.
Damn. Well, we get married. shout out, I love you, baby. Pornhub is giving out an introduction deal for $2.99. I don't know why everything is $2.99.
$2.99?
No, for $299, Pornhub will give you a lifetime subscription. Lifetime subscription, ladies and gentlemen, to Pornhub for $299. And I don't know how they're going to go with this as far as password and login sharing, because
Netflix, you can motherfucking.
Hey, no, we don't.
You can put 19 niggas on an account on Netflix.
We all get our streaming in the right way. We pay for it. We log in exclusively, and we use in your streaming platforms, and we want to thank you for it. But Pornhub is offering people a chance to have porn for life for $300. Now, would I think that's... Do I think it's a great idea? No. Because it's done...
Shit already free.
Right. It's Don Gotti...
Shit already free.
In our previous staff meeting. It's free.
You're charging, but they probably got some added
the premium. Shit. Hey, it's enough shit on there to where you don't need the full video. You need that 5 minutes they got you on. Unless they start just cutting the video off.
Yeah, but you know some niggas is like savages.
Hey, dude,
it's enough on there.
You can go on there. I mean, it's too much.
You can watch everything on
there. Yeah, you can watch everything.
I don't really know too much about porn like that, man. I get confused. Yeah.
Pornhub. You know, shout out to Pornhub. I mean, this is kind of ridiculous.
I watch Spankwire.
Spankwire.
Shout out Spankwire.
I've never heard Spankwire.
Get that commercial. I need to represent Spankwire.
Yeah.
You know, get it in with y'all. You know what I'm saying? But even
that's
still,
the ultimate gift. You know what? I'm just thinking about stocking stuffers. Fleshlights and lifetime subscriptions to Pornhub.
And Spankwire.
It's Spankwire. Lifetime subscription, Pornhub, Spankwire, and Fleshlights.
If you don't know about Fleshlights, go check back episode.
Is it six?
Put you on
check
game.
Us out on IG. I have it on IG. You can actually check us out.
How they find you on IG, dog?
I think it's PY. I mean, FYO. I always get it confused because we spell it different than we say it. But it is FYO. Or just type in "fuck your opinion"
on Instagram
is PHUCK your opinion.
Okay.
And you look us up on IG. Yes. I'm always gonna post small segments and things from Taco Tuesday, Thursdays, and "fuck your opinion" Fridays on IG. Is gonna be questions that you can get interactive with. It's fucking social media. You know how that shit work. But back to what I was saying. Pornhub is giving lifetime subscription. I'm with God. I mean, now let me put it this way. If I had the money to just say, you know what? Fuck it. I want a life. Because they do have Prime. Have you ever been to Pornhub? They got the little videos that it's a star beside it. Then you pluck on that. Because when you click on that, you're like, oh, this must be the best one here. It got some, black Amazon chick that's like at least 5'11" and she's spinning another chick around and they just going at it. He like, damn, this is 69, vertical 69 with two women. And then you turn around and say, wait a minute, I want to watch this video. They give you like the first 2 or 3 minutes and bang, they just fade out. Then they go, you got to get Prime.
You got to order.
You got to get the Prime subscription.
Put your credit card in the junk.
And you be like, why is the best one? I got to look at the grainy, the grainy home videos where some shit look like I'm having
sex. Or like when you be trying to search for like transvestites having sex and then, wait a minute. Who do that?
Yeah, I don't know.
Listen, hey, that's a joke.
Some people do put the duck in the bushes because a couple of times I went past some shit and was like, wait a minute. And how you scroll and you scroll quickly, but your eyes, and they say you can't unsee something. So you might be scrolling through videos and you see a video that looked quite awkward. You'd be like, wait a minute, those two people both look masculine in that last clip. I don't want to go back to make sure I seen it because I feel strange in
a
sense.
Not to get off topic real quick, but I mean, shit like that hit fuck you up, right? So a couple months ago, I was talking to a female on the phone. Now, I'm saying her name. I don't put nobody under the bus. And she was telling me how her fiance, she found pop-ups in his computer of transvestite dating sites, transvestite porn. So I told her, I said, look, man, if he's inquiring information like that, it's almost 100% sure he wants to either A, fuck one of them.
He's gay. Ladies and gentlemen, we have, and listen, I want to let you people say this. I'm going to let you finish. The LGBTQ community, we have no problem,
y'all.
We have family members, we have friends that are part of all these groups.
No quarrel with y'all.
But at the same time, we are willing and well aware of what we say, and we can say what the fuck we want to say.
It's our opinion.
We might not mean to offend, but we definitely mean to say how we feel about the subject. So go ahead.
So while I was explaining to the young lady that,
he's gay.
Hold up.
Tank said you got three times. Suck a dick.
No, I ain't got fucking Tank gave it suck.
Two. He said two.
He said two.
I don't know if it's something. So hold up.
Tank, full of shit.
So he said the third time you went over.
So anyway, while I'm telling
you,
just because
he's scrolling doesn't make him gay.
I'm just quoting the tape.
Bullshit.
According to
Tank. Listen, while I'm explaining to the young lady my thoughts, only my opinion, which were, you know, your fiance is gay. Right. My homeboy, one of my very close friends, I shall not say a name.
Oh, shit.
But he was like, well, you know, it's been a time where I had a problem going on with me and my lady, and I was looking on transvestite porn sites because I wanted to see about a nigga sucking a dick or woo. And I was like, so he was trying to like explain to it, and I had to stop and look over the nigga like, what, nigga? You was looking at what?
He was looking at a dude.
He said he had thought about or inquired information about
on a porn site,
looking at a transvestite porn site about a, you know,
dude. I mean, well, look, hey, man, transvestite.
So that right there just threw me off. I don't mean to get off the topic.
Do they even use that anymore? That's old school, ain't it?
Transvestite. I thought that was the T. LGBT.
But so they don't say transvestite.
Oh, is it transition? Like
trans.
Right. Trans?
Yeah.
Transition?
But I know it used to be the old...
Well, trans, listen, whatever the case may be, if you're a woman, a man that puts on women makeup and if transitions yourself to look like a woman but you still got wood, and there's some video where a guy is actually decided to do that, you may be a transvestite, but if that guy is gay, okay, anytime that, I don't give it, if it is a woman with a penis and you decide to suck it, You're gay. Okay.
Yeah,
now, I mean, some of us may have seen some large clitorises in there. I mean, but if it got balls attached to it, dude, you can't just say I have sex with transvestites. You got to say I have sex with men that dress up like women.
Or you can't say, you know, every now and then.
Or trans.
Every now and then I let a man give me head, but I still love women.
Did he say that? What did he say?
What?
Huh?
I said you cannot say.
You
cannot say every now and then. I let a man give me head, but I go back home to my lady, my wife. I'm not gay. No, if you let a man put their mouth on your penis, you are gay.
And make sure that.
Or if you give a man fellatio, you are gay.
And if anybody hears anything different than what Steph said in the playback.
Yeah.
I ain't saying nothing.
Hey. Nah, because I just caught you saying that shit. I'm like, oh, shit.
Y'all wanted me to say
something. No, we don't want you to say something.
Y'all tried to catch me. Catch me on a tank incident. You ain't about to take me. That's going to be the new thing in 2020. I'm trying to take me.
You know we can chop that shit
up. Everybody go to Instagram on the playback. You might put that on Instagram on the playback.
If you want to see the rest of this episode.
Just if you want to see. Thanksgiving Thursday.
Mark my words, that's going to be the new thing in 2020?
It's 2019. We're going to 2020.
2020.
2020 is going to be. Don't be trying to take me, dog.
Listen. Or whatever the case may be, back to Pornhub. If you're the type of person that's seen that on Pornhub site, you flicked or whatever, that's
$299.
But for $299, you can get the premium, and that means that's the good shit in HD, not that grainy shit where you people. You know, one thing I know about watching porn, I've loved. I do actually enjoy the actual art of scene setups, because sometimes, you know, you go watch like the house hood porn. It'd be like dirty laundry and shit.
That's raw, you know what I'm saying? It'd be an old tank top
hanging over the edge of the motherfucker.
Pit bull running around licking their
ass. This is not the point.
Roaches on the wall.
A part of me still wants a guy to show up with a pizza and two bad bitches answer the door half-ass naked. And that's just a part of me. I just like, that's me. Give me that. I like the fantasy part of it. I don't want to see
I like the porn where the nigga just be riding down the road. We got a bag full of money. Be like, hey, come here, sweetheart. I give you $1,000. Come fuck me. I'm going to put it on camera.
The bang bus is pretty cool.
I like the mom jumps. Like, with the mom.
The milk.
Yeah, the milk.
I love me a milk.
Yeah.
Ooh.
You know, I had a discussion with someone the other day. They actually thought those mommy-son joints was real.
Oh, that's horrible.
I was like, no. I was like, they're actors, babe. I'm like, the sickest part is they're just portraying mothers having sex with sons. But
well, most of them is moms having sex with stepsons.
Yeah, but it's not even, they're really actors.
But to be honest, everybody has those little light fantasies.
I mean, so that really taps into the sickness.
Well, have you ever had a dream about having sex with your mom?
Well, not your mom, but I'm talking about like your friend's mom.
No.
I'm talking about your friend's mom.
That could be a fucked up
friend's
dream.
Mom?
Yeah. I ain't
never had a friend's mom.
Like, I got a friend.
I will fuck the shit out of her.
My homeboy mother, she bad. I will fuck the shit out of her.
I've never had a...
I ain't about to say her name.
This must be wrong.
You know who your mother is, because I'm your father. I've been saying I'm your father for how many years? I will slut your mother the fuck out, eat her butt, all that shit. You'll come over and I'll be in the living room playing PlayStation, man. You'll be like, Joey. Fuck this nigga step in the house for.
That's Joey. Hey, remember I was talking about in the last episode, just PlayStation cords and shit y'all missing?
She'll be like, you come in the house?
And you can't find your PlayStation power when you're missing the controller and shit. Bow, right there.
Talking about, you ain't tell me that nigga stuff on eight ass. Like, what the fuck?
And that's how you got out the house with your controller. He just was like, can I have this shit? He's like, you don't need that, baby.
Some niggas' mothers out there can get that work.
That's what that shit
does. I mean, Pornhub basically taps into all the inner... sexual deviant demons that live
and
the shit inside,
huh?
And the shit free.
And
most of it's free.
Hey, man, y'all go ahead and drop that $2.99.
I mean, they gotta drop that shit, man. Come on, man.
Get that deal, dog. We trying to get a commercial.
$49.99 for life.
$2.99 coming, man. Go get that. Drop that money, man. Y'all niggas got that bag, man. Y'all some freaks. Man, some niggas gonna beat themselves to death with that $2.99, man. Y'all gonna be beating y'all dick more.
And you know what?
Rain, this is sleep, shine, motherfucker.
You know what? This is another part of the story I find just kind of fucked up. PayPal actually turned off payments to Pornhub. It dropped all subscriptions through PayPal, and they said they had to lay off almost 100,000 adult workers because PayPal decided to cut off mostly. That's a lot of their lifeblood because people, you know, they don't want to use their main credit card, so they go through PayPal, use that to pay for subscriptions.
So we need to come up with another credit card
We need a slutty card. We need to, hey, if you're out there and fuck you got your, a credit card company.
Fuck Your Opinion presents
the slutty card. And we put a fleshlight on the card.
A fleshlight?
Not the weird ones, but the actual
your picture don't be on it, be you with a mask on.
And a fleshlight on your credit card. And you use that to pay for all the schmuck. And you want to there. I mean, it got to be certain, you know, I don't know. Because I think we'll get too dark after that.
We've already got dark shit.
But anyway, you know, hey, yeah. It's Thanksgiving.
$2.99.
So tomorrow, get off your ass and get on the internet, and you can't use PayPal in those
schmucks
that's trying to hide their be a deviant like the rest of us and put it on your bank statement.
I really hope that they give you some type of incentives, you know, t-shirts.
At least like if they're having some kind of porn conventions or something like that.
Or they can give you one of those fake jumps you can fuck you or something.
Fleshlight.
I mean, they got the fleshlight, but they got the Jones just got the ass and shit.
Yeah, torso. Like vicious. Like the male torso.
They got the
we put it on our page where remember the females were commenting about the male torso with the big hard dick just sticking up. They got the one for the men too. We got the
fat ass, drill
the shit out that junk.
Just go to work on it.
Kill it.
Oh my god! Power wash that motherfucker when you finish. Though you
nasty motherfucker.
Yeah, that's too much. Like if we talked about that before, but
can you imagine getting caught by your girl?
And the funniest thing is when drumming she walk junk? In, yeah. When she walk in, she ain't gonna think. She gonna think you going to work. She gonna go to kick the bitch in the head and slip across the whole top of the bed.
What the fuck? We actually did talk about this before.
We talked about this on the unreleased episode. We might bring that up. The last episode. If I can fuck with this audio, we're gonna get that.
So yeah, listen. If I can do something with the audio on that,
I
always tell you, whenever you tune into these three brothers right here, we gonna go deep, baby. We're going deep. But anyway, Pornhub, if you're listening, you got to take advice from these three handsome motherfuckers right here, because we know what we're talking about. Give out some fleshlights, some booty meat, starter kits and all that shit. If you want somebody to do something for $2.99, t-shirts, tickets to a porn.
Put $2.99. Put that ass with it, man.
Put that ass with it.
Put that ass in.
And that sounds like a con. That sounds like some oil. You know,
some of that oil you put on your dick and it make your dick hot.
Yeah.
Come with a pack.
I didn't even know about that. Step.
You ain't never had that. They can sell that at Walmart, a Target.
No.
But you and your wife, you can get it.
You know what? I never went to Target and thought, let me get the hot nigga.
You can go to Target right now and get the joint set. His and hers. It's a little joint you put on your finger, and you hit a little button, and it goes. And then you put a ring around the bottom of your joint. Yeah, you go to work, Joe.
So what do you do with the buzzing finger?
You play with the buzzing.
Oh, so you get a cock ring and a finger buzzer from Target
for under $20, y'all.
Ladies and gentlemen, Target has been sneaking.
I got one right next to the bed, next to my bed.
So that lets you know, moms, dads, please keep your kids in certain sections of Target keep your kids out of certain parts of Target that you might have to make some kind of excuse for when your kid runs and say, "Mommy, is this your finger?" Whatever it is, you know.
It's not
but anyway, Pornhub, like we say, man, give up, do something. You gotta do something. You gotta step your game up. For $300, you already get what they say. Why pay for the cow if you get the milk for free? What the fuck am I paying for the cow?
Right.
But the rest of the cow tastes so much better than the milk.
See, we just saying. Milk.
Steaks taste better than milk.
Yeah.
Hot dog, cheeseburgers and shit taste better than milk.
Yeah, but they just saying, like, the milk. And
I know this person.
Did they actually slaughter the cow and kill it?
We ain't even about to go that far.
I mean, listen, we all going to talk.
Hey, pour it up. Fuck your opinion, man.
Yeah. This ain't fuck your opinion Friday.
Happy Thanksgiving, though. Hope y'all had a good meal.
Yeah, hope y'all are still having it, man. Watch this. We're going to...
Thanksgiving is all day, man.
Yeah, all day. You know, watch this, laugh, and maybe spark up some interesting conversations while you're sitting there doing that. Speaking of this wonderful day, here on Thanksgiving Thursday, I got some Thanksgiving tips. You might say this is for the brothers and sisters in which, you know, black
people. We're going to say it's for everybody.
But it's for everybody because everybody
we are multicultural here.
Listen, everybody has family members with the same characteristics. They might be different in color, and different in name, but they all act the same.
I told you, everybody's not that different. Growing up as a black and white male, they're not that different.
You may be my brother, but it don't matter if you're black or white. It was something to say, you may not be my brother, whatever the fuck, but you know what I'm saying. When he had the video where his motherfuckers was shaking. Michael Jackson was the first to really be giving you that shit in videos with the morphine and all that shit. Shout outs to Mike. But anyway, these are some Thanksgiving tips.
Toucan Dan.
If you have not been to the house yet or on your way to the house, if you still cooking, whatever. Whatever you fucking doing, you pay attention to these tips because these might save your life and your relationships with your loved ones. All right. Rule number one for my Thanksgiving tip. No fuck buddies or 2 month hookups. That's a plus one. If you're gonna bring somebody past your family members home around your family, let it not be somebody who you just met at the motherfucking stadium or whatever clubs in your fucking area, and you hit it like a couple of weeks ago, and you was like, I want to impress her, so I'm taking over my mama's house. She could have been a potential one night stand, or even if it's 2 months, if you don't really know this motherfucker, don't bring it around me, because I don't want to really have to remember this son of a bitch's name if I'm only going to see him in Thanksgiving and never see him again by the time fucking New Year's come. Because then you show up at the next joint with another dude, and we say joint in D.C. or the next place, the next event, with a whole new fucking dude, and, you know, we your family members, so we're going to love you and not consider you a fucking slut.
We call you a different nigga name and shit.
Right, like, oh, well, then you look like, well, don't ask me about Antoine. Well, fucking, I only seen Antoine 2 months ago. What the fuck happened to him? But anyway, no fuck buddies or 2 month hookups. Y'all agree with that?
Yeah, that basically don't bring no new dick and new pussy around the family.
Yeah, it's got to be.
That'll be at least longer than 4 months.
Right, at least attend the birthday party first. If it's a birthday party and you bring them to the birthday party,
nigga coming.
Shit, I think it should be a year longer.
Right, I'm just saying, but somebody always has a birthday party.
That's a little too old fashioned, man.
No, but listen, I'm just saying, at least give us a birthday party.
You know, listen, you know, niggas and women nowadays are so thirsty that they just want.
Because four months can still be in the.
You're right. 4 months, you won't. After Thanksgiving, you won't see
that. What I'm saying is, if they first bring the same person to, say, a birthday party, they kind of. So by the time they get to Thanksgiving, you see what I'm saying? They're like, hey, okay, we kind of met the guy before. He was at so and so birthday party. He ain't as new.
Yeah, you can't show up. Thanksgiving can't be the first time you show up.
Yeah,
gotta break you in.
Yeah, I mean, I ain't coming Thanksgiving Day, no way. They can put me under the microscope.
Yeah, I don't want that shit anyway. I never had to deal with that shit.
And that goes for ladies and men, because some of y'all do that shit. Y'all just be like, hey, he's my friend. If it's just your friend, why the fuck he ain't eating his family house? But anyway.
Your nasty ass wife folks food that, no. Then you got all this, go be a black folk, they got all the seasoning shit, you got diabetes.
Whoever house you going over,
their family, look at this big red nigga, you just brought in here to eat all our food up.
Right, and we don't even really know this motherfucker at all. All right, so number two, do not bring up old shit that is a certified buzzkill. To me, this is what I mean by that, if you need some further instructional information. Fucking spider. You know, sometimes we get around family members, they want to bring up some shit that really ain't appropriate for, you know, holidays. You know, sometimes you be around your family or folks or cousin, you know, yeah, remember that time, man, we was out there, you know what I'm saying, that nigga knocked you out, we was at the motherfucking basketball court, nigga stole the shit out, you remember this shit, all that shit was funny. To everybody else it might be funny, but to you like, motherfucker,
well, fuck you.
Right, nigga,
I got knocked out.
Right, nigga knocked you the fuck out, remember that shit, nigga, you was all snoring, your mouth was busted on.
That's the type
nigga.
Shit I be doing, nigga. Niggas be mad as shit, man. Fuck you, step.
And so, you know, I mean, anything that's fucked up that happened to a family member, don't bring that shit up around other family members and friends and be a butt. And then, you know, it sucks the air out the room. You know, they be saying some stupid shit that.
Yeah, really, but a lot of fans, you know, we like that shit, though. So.
I mean, but, you know, don't be a butt, but sometimes you can say certain shit that just, like I say, sucks the air out the room.
All right, what else you got? Come on, give me.
What else? Oh,
it might be like a. Bringing up an old chick or some shit.
Yeah, anything, you know. Or one time a motherfucker crashed your car and he owed you some money and you was trying to say it like a joke, but you really meant that shit was serious, so everybody get kind of quiet.
Yeah, you always bring the bad jokes over here.
You be like, yeah, man, y'all trying to go to the club after this? Yeah, nigga, but you ain't never got no motherfucking money. Just keep that.
Nigga. I'm dating a broke nigga?
Oh, you know what I'm saying? And you got your plus one with you. Niggas just put you out there. But number three, tell your aunt or aunt, whatever, that she cannot beat up her husband because of 20 or more years because he weighs at least 30 pounds less than she does and he's an alcoholic. Because some of us got that uncle that's cool and shit, but he's our aunt's uncle. He drink like a motherfucking fish.
Yeah, little nigga too.
And he little. Nigga probably weigh like 115 pounds, but he cool.
Talk shit, cool.
But he cool, and he smoke, and he'll let you always get a cigarette from him. You know, but then him and your aunt get into it.
Uncle Rowdy.
Uncle Rowdy. He making everybody laugh, but for some reason, everything he say get on your aunt's motherfucking nerves, so she just cusses him out.
He get drunk and she beat him up.
Right, and then she get drunk, and then he go to hit it back, and then now we got to whoop his ass. Even though it's your uncle and you know this nigga 20 years, you call him Uncle Rowdy, but you had to smack the shit out of him just because he jumped on your aunt. And that's just family rules, nigga. You jump on my aunt. Even though if you're my uncle of 20 years, I still got to stomp you out because that's what happened.
Hey, happy belated birthday to Rowdy, too, nigga. Love you, baby.
Happy birthday, Rowdy.
That's tip number three. Man. Tell your auntie she can't fight your drunk uncle, especially if he cool.
Right.
All right, this is another one. Number four, tell your aunt or uncle to stop walking around and telling everybody, this is my mama house. You know, you always got that motherfucking family member that every time somebody get a gathering together over your mother's house, they want to be the favorite. They want to tell everybody, yeah, this is my mama house. Mama know how I like it, you know, when mama always got this, and when mama knows I'm going to do this for her. Mom, this is my mama house. You know, somebody asks you to use the bathroom. Yeah, you're my mother's house. You can use the bathroom. You be like, let me tell you something, you self-righteous son of a bitch. This is everybody's mama house, and the goddamn sink been broke for 2.5 months. You ain't had nobody fix it. This your mama's house.
You don't take the trash out.
You don't take the trash out. The goddamn railing to go up the stairs still got only 3 screws in it. Mama almost broke her goddamn back walking up the steps trying to hold on to the rail. And you over here telling everybody this my mama's house. And they got the nerve
to be inviting motherfuckers over that don't even be bringing nothing.
Right, motherfuckers just show up and only got thing he got is a cigarette in his mouth. And you talking about, oh, this my friend.
With a three pack, it was a 6 pack, but they come over with three beers.
A 3 pack of Budweiser.
And they want to drink out the rest of your
and
shit.
And she's talking, oh, this is my friend. He's so nice and respectful. And then try to, and maybe tell everybody, this is my mama house. Shut your ass.
So basically, stop saying it's your motherfucking house when it's not.
Your mama love everybody. That's why we all here. Number 5, bring games the whole family can play. Because if you got idle time and too many people, then people start too much shit. So if people get drunk and you got games or board games, whatever the fuck, black people's usually dominoes or card games. Now, spades. Dominoes and spades, as long as nobody start gambling, the evening may be safe. If anybody start bringing cash out their pockets on Thanksgiving or dominoes or spades,
put some money on it, nigga. Put some money on it.
Then fuck you all. Whatever else is in the house, the grandma, the aunt, or whatever, be like, y'all ain't gonna be doing that gambling shit in my house, especially on the day for family. Make sure that happens, because you know when niggas start putting money on the table, they gonna get to fighting.
Put up then.
Somebody gonna cheat and somebody gonna get to swinging.
Cheat, motherfucker.
Number 6.
Bitch ass. It's got to be some words.
Yeah. Bitch ass, bitch nigga. Ass, nigga. Yeah, this bitch ass. He can't whoop me on nothing.
Can't whoop. Can't nobody even motherfucking whoop.
You can't see me with his hands. You might have beat me in spades.
Next you know, the whole y'all trying to go outside and the family trying to get y'all to calm down. So y'all first cousins, man. Stop it.
Fuck
yeah.
That nigga.
And his mama. Whoa.
She the one made that nasty ass potato salad.
Ain't nobody eat that shit.
Yeah, so keep the games and fun and games for your family, but make sure it's nothing that can end up in a war. Number 6, this is for my esteemed Toucan fam. Keep a fresh shirt or cologne in the car if you plan on hitting that loud pack. Now, some of these youngins, they're a little bit disrespectful. In my day, you know, I'm not old, but in the days when I was a youngin', I wouldn't go anybody's house booming. You know what I'm saying?
Boofing. That's a big word.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Boofing. If you come into somebody's house and you boofed
out.
You know, you kind of disrespect, especially the old people.
That means you smell like a pound of motherfucking weed.
Right.
Hot weed.
Right. Yeah, we call it the loud pack.
You don't want
Nana coughing and choking off you as you was. She almost swallowed her teeth. Because you walked past her and you was boofing so hard that she couldn't even take a damn inhale. She already got an oxygen tank and you just knocking the whole goddamn
room. Motherfucker, Uncle Bill, rest his soul, used to say, come in here smelling like that shit. Get out there smoking that shit, boy. Yeah.
Yeah, so
smoking that reefer.
That's what it is. So, you know, if you're going to be out there partaking in your thing, getting, you know, whatever, getting your hunger up, just keep a fresh shirt and some cologne in the car.
Febreze,
you know.
Get you a bottle of that motherfucking Febreze. Body spray that motherfucking face, nigga.
Real cologne, not that I do twice shit. Get you some real cologne.
Yeah, but you know what, though? And that's another thing we wanted to do. My man Josh Prey just did a thing on his show where he put grown men, young men, onto the cologne game. That's one thing we got to do here on Fuck Your Opinion. You know, we got to help y'all out one day and show y'all what colognes you can and cannot do, what can cover up, what cannot cover up. Because some nigga just can't be spraying Dracar. That toilet water.
Yeah. Hey, look, coming to your Taco Tuesdays, we're going to have a man talk on how to smell. How to make yourself more fragrantly appealing.
Cologne can get y'all buzzy.
Real cologne, not that old toilet shit.
Not that buzz shit.
All right, that's number 6. Keep a fresh shirt and some cologne. Number 7, don't get too drunk over strangers or non-family members' houses. Shit. Meaning, if you are the plus one and you're lucky enough to come, or the guest, have a small or a decent amount of liquor where you learn to still be respectful and understand that that is not your family and not your home, because a lot of times that leads to people getting their ass whipped.
Yes, but don't go get fucked up.
Don't get fucked up because then, you know, it might be that cute cousin or somebody's fine girlfriend. It might be, you know, somebody's nephew's girlfriend that you over there hitting on, and he done told you at least two other times, and she done told you at least once to cut it out, so nigga decided to knock your ass out, and since it's family, you probably going to get your ass whipped.
Damn, girl, you know, you's a bad no motherfucker.
Right, man, you know, she's like, you see my boyfriend standing over there, you see my man right there, you need to cut that shit out. Hey, the nigga's like, hey, what's your problem? Because I ain't got no problem, nigga. What's your... Now, don't forget, you still a stranger on strange land, because blood is thicker than mud, and you might get your ass whipped by a whole family. Just like Uncle Roddy, once the shit go down, people going to start swinging on anybody that's not next to kin. All right? So don't get too drunk over fucking other people's homes. Number eight.
Hey, how many goddamn things you got, man?
We only got 10, baby.
Come on with it.
Eight. Number eight. Stay long enough to justify you taking four or more plates. And that is not or including cakes
and
pies.
Man, fuck that. Take one and a half plate.
Man, we black. You know we take it. Man, one plate gonna have turkey and ham on it.
Look here,
another
man.
Plate gonna have the greens.
You ain't coming to my
mama.
I was taking no four plates.
Macaroni and cheese and stuffing. And then you got the third plate with all the odd shit like devil eggs and cabbage or rice and peas.
We cut that shit out.
Listen, we got three plates. And then
You can get two. Two on a possible.
Listen, then the fourth one is your dessert, bro.
Two on a possible, bro.
Listen, the first plate is always the
dessert.
You got your meats on your first plate.
Four plates is ridiculous.
Second plate is your sides. Third plate is the sides that nobody really ate.
Now, it also depends how much food you brought.
No, I'm talking about, we had a fucking feast.
But just because you come to a nigga house for three, four hours don't mean you automatically get four plates.
But it depends how much food you had. My family, they always have enough food where you can get, okay, so that depends on the family size. Also, learn know your limits.
Adequacy.
Know your limits. Now, if you go to a whole house and it's a full buffet and this shit just seems like it's pouring out of the sky, you know, as long as you don't disrespect. I mean, this is for family members. It's not for strangers. For family members. If you're over someone's house and you've been there long enough where you say, I'm going to wrap me up in that little plate, wrap up two, sneak them to the car.
But that's what they do. They're already steaming.
Yeah, sneak them two to the car. And then when you come back, and then grab them.
Don't be stacking up motherfucking plates, man.
Yeah, no, don't stack out for you. You got to sneak two to the car.
You know what's going to happen? You're not going to be invited to a lot of functions.
Well, sneak two to a car. If you want to take four, sneak two to the car.
You know what I'm saying?
So that's rule number eight.
You be wondering, like, damn, man, motherfucker, cut the stack, have a cookout. I ain't get the motherfucker invited, nigga. You be stacking plates, nigga.
Right. So listen to step. Don't stack. Listen to me and Don. Take two to the car. Come back. Wait. And then when somebody offer you another
ninja shit, be on your ninja shit.
And when somebody offer you another two plates, you got four. Yeah. But they only offered you two.
No stacking.
Got it. All right. Number nine. Watch your kids if they're uncontrollable. And I'm saying that to be PC instead of saying. Look after your badass kids. If your kids are prone to fucking up other people's shit, don't leave them unattended in people's homes. Because it's always, let me tell you something, this scenario I always go through. You hear a lot of
what the fuck was that?
And then you hear,
boom!
And then everybody stop. And you hear,
God damn it, motherfucker.
And then everybody stop. And all the adults stop. You know why all the adults stop? Because everybody's trying to ping their kid.
See, figure out who the hell kid
they pinging their kid. Like, is that my kid? No, that ain't my kid. Is that there was somebody know?
That's my kid.
Yeah,
I know it's mine.
And then, you know, you got to be, you know, if your kid get that, well, tell your kid like everybody else was told. When we get over here, don't act up, don't cut up, so you don't get fucked up.
Hey, but if it's your mama house, you good.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, if it's grandma's house,
you know.
Yeah, if your mama's house, you're good.
Grandma gonna have to do what the fuck they want, though.
Yeah, but I'm talking about if you bringing your children over other people's
houses.
If you bringing them my motherfucking house,
yeah.
Put the motherfucker, keep them in check.
Keep them, before you get there, look, this is Mr. Step House, this is Mr. Toucan.
That's why this year I don't have it in my house.
You know,
right here in the Fuck Your Opinion building. Because I ain't want niggas in my house like that this year.
Right.
I even brought my dog here.
See? So, I mean, Step made it a family affair and a family environment.
That's it.
So make sure you do that for your kids, man. Don't have them sliding down people's stairs and shit.
And I designated one room.
Right.
Well, put padding on the walls.
Hey, damn.
Yeah.
Should have put a bouncy house in it. But anyway, number 9, watch your uncontrollable
ass. Watch your motherfucking kids. Children.
Number 10. Number 10, this is the final. Drum roll, please. Number 10 on my list of turkey tips for Thanksgiving. Never fuck up somebody else's toilet and silently leave. And that goes for if you are not a person, even for family members, if your ass don't regularly sit on someone's toilet that owns the house, don't fuck their toilet up and just leave. Damn. Don't let somebody discover that y'all done fucked the upstairs bathroom after everybody told you don't take your motherfucking ass. The hostess of the house, first of all, as a host, you should always keep a backup plunger for those occasions, because sometimes people even a little bit finicky, but they don't even want to plunge somebody else's shit. But they, you know, whatever, that's getting too personal, but I'm just putting it out there. We got people that's control freaks like that. But put an extra plunge in whatever toilet you're going to let your family use or facilities. And for God's sake, if someone tell you don't go upstairs and take a shit, don't go upstairs and take a massive shit in someone's personal bathroom. And then creep downstairs and take your ass home and don't know. Because then after a while, you know, you clean up, you go upstairs, you ready to unwind, you ready to sip a little wine or, you know, whatever. And then you go look in your bathroom upstairs and somebody left toilet paper and a massive ass shit in your toilet. And then that's when black people go to cussing everybody out. I ain't letting them. That's why I told them motherfuckers. I ain't never let. You know what? Next time, we not having this shit over my house. And see, that's when Steph probably went through that situation where somebody fucked this toilet up. Yep. You know what he said?
No more.
We ain't having this shit over my house. Motherfuckers can't never disrespect or respect nobody's shit. Who gonna come in here taking shit? And you don't know. You can't call up family members and friends. Like, yo, was you the one took that massive shit in my bathroom?
That's why you gotta have more camera, man. You had that shit. Had the camera in the hallway. You see the motherfucker coming out kind of.
Right. You like this? Then, you know what? This 2020. This 2020. Don Dottie Nash got your ass on camera.
Oh, yeah. I got you a
fuck in the bathroom. So if you get a call after the event is over and Don Gotti Nash go, you dirty stink ass motherfucker. You go, what I do, Don? No, you, I seen you, nigga. Hey, you took that shit.
Back. You coming back to clean that shit up.
You coming back. You don't bring your black ass back here. I'm coming to your house and I'm going to take a
hey, and listen. Shit. Don't flush wet wipes down the toilet.
Don't flush wet wipes
down the toilet. Don't flush them. You got to dry wipe first. Then you go wet wipe. And then you wrap and throw them in the trash can.
Well, I'm guilty. I put wet wipes in the toilet.
You do? And yours? Yeah. Your own toilet? Yeah. Oh, your shit gonna be fucked up, bro.
I mean, I was not, but then my wife was like, yo, put that shit in the toilet. I was like, yo, it ain't supposed to go in the toilet. It says on the package, do not put in the toilet. She was like, you can flush them. I flush mine. So I said, hey, I ain't gonna keep being the one.
Serious fuck listen, up in a minute.
All I'm gonna do is act like I don't know nothing about that shit and have maintenance come take care of it. Because that was her idea. I love you, baby. But, like I said, man, that was number 10. Never fuck up strangers or your family members' toilets and leave without saying, and I know it's embarrassing. Nobody wants to sit there because you know the most embarrassing thing is when you flush and that shit go. Yeah, and you be like, oh, I ain't get that. Bah, whoosh, I got that.
That'd be the fucked up feeling, dog.
You be like, oh, my God.
Damn, I just fucked this joint out. This nigga ain't got no plunger in his
drink. So and that's on the floor. If you throw in a party, you hosting, I'm going to step. Keep go. I mean, go
if you ain't got a plunger, I'm rolling.
Go buy a plunger, man. If you got company, you know people coming over your house. Maybe not the toilet brush plunger combo, but go get a small utility plunger so whoever fuck your bathroom up, at least they can have decency to plunge that shit. Don't have
to. You might have to write a note and just.
Because some people be embarrassed. I mean, you got to think, you fuck a toilet up, and it's about 30 people outside the downstairs. You don't want to just go and say, hey, man. Because, you know, black people, we going to tell everybody. White folks, so I don't know how Spanish people, but black folks, you might whisper in somebody's ear, hey, man, I fucked the toilet upstairs. Damn, nigga, you took a monster shit. Where you shit at? Upstairs? Man, ain't nobody go upstairs. Such as my man, he done fucked the bathroom. Black people ain't gonna keep nothing discreet. We gonna tell everybody, you know, yourself, you know, you might catch Big Mama and be like, Mama, you done fucked the toilet upstairs? She like, shut your mouth. You can just go over and clean that shit. But anyway, like I said, just, you know, is if you hosting a party, keep a plunger, some wet wipes, and make sure it's a nice area for your guests so they don't have to fuck your bathroom up. And that's my 10 topics for Thanksgiving tips, and I hope you all enjoy this wonderful day. give praise and thanks with your family. I want to give a shout out to my uncle, Barry Francis. He passed away on Sunday. He was a very important person in my life, very strong man, very great ancestor roots. And, you know, as men, we learn that we not always going to be right. We damn sure ain't going to always be wrong, but it's hard for us to sometimes be right. But, you know, people got to learn to love and respect the men that we are and that we have in our lives, because we're all men sitting here with children. And, you know, it comes to a time when we're going to get old, and the mistakes that we made and the mistakes our children have made, we got to learn to get past that shit. But I want to give a shout out and a spiritual shout out to my uncle, Barry Francis. May you rest in peace and, you know, enjoy.
Uncle, rest in peace, Uncle Barry.
Yeah, you know, you're there with your mom. You know, your mom, my aunt, my grandmother, Vicky, she passed a few years ago. So,
hey, that's wild.
You know, it's just to a point where, you know, at least they get to have a share that dance, that dance together in eternity.
Hey, real quick before we do our thing, I want to give a special shout out. My uncle died as well. Big Bill, a.k.a. Willie Smith. He died last Friday, this past Friday.
Rest in prayer,
rest in peace.
Willie Smith.
Rest in peace, Bill. Uncle Bill passed away, man. Great dude, man. You know what I mean? He passed away on JoJo's birthday, man, last Friday. Like I say, man.
We all move on, but...
Yeah, we moving on. I'm lost for words, but I really appreciate the dude.
And we thank you for the memories, man. Uncle Bill.
Yeah, Uncle Bill.
Thank you for the memories, Uncle Bill.
Took care of me, my son, a hard-working man. Very old-fashioned, kept the hood rolling, gave us hell, grew to be a great dude, man. Changed his ways to the point where my kids and people that we're around now never knew the Big Bill we knew in the hood. Burlington Road, 4621 Burlington Road. We lost a good one, man. Big Bill, rest in peace. Your wife came and got you on her birthday, man. I love you. Rest in peace. Prayers for the family, man. You know how we do it, man.
That's right.
Flowers for the dead.
And on that note, we thankful for you. We thankful for our family.
Yes, thank you to the viewers, man.
Thank you for tuning in. You know, even if you haven't tuned in.
Real quick, just give us two things you thankful for, guy. Real quick, Thanksgiving.
I'm thankful for life and family, man.
There we go, Dad.
I'm thankful for life, family, and those trees that grow.
Awesome. I'm thankful for... my family, man, who is growing, because our family is our friends on Facebook, our members, my children.
Facebook family, Instagram family. Listen, we all love.
I'm thankful for everyone, because I don't do friends. I do family. I'm also thankful for this life that we have, because it's not promised to none of us. Enjoy that food.
Hear that train
pull out. Understand that there's people out here that don't get to eat like you eat.
Definitely be thankful for, and then, you know, help out those who are less need.
I mean, that's it, man. Just be thankful for life in general, man. And once again, remember, God is good, the sky is blue, and water is wet. And fuck your opinion.
That's Friday, so tune in.
See you tomorrow.
Get y'all a little old school music.
I'm about to eat some dessert and shit.
Oh, yeah, man. I got to give me another. I got to get another plate in, man.
Get you another dessert.
Yeah. Call my baby, so I'll put it in the mic. Let me tell you something. If you keep cake in the microwave, I'm on project status right now. I ain't real pretty. I can't get a glass dish. But I don't like putting desserts in the refrigerator, because I feel like it takes away from it when it's cold. So when you got some good fucking desserts, put this in
the refrigerator. Give y'all a little bean and seed. Happy Thanksgiving, motherfuckers. Fuck your opinion.
It may cause drowsiness.
Don't drink none of this shit right here and eat all the turkey. You're gonna be fucked up.
I'm on the back, crack a duck, have a sizzle. Get introduced to this drink, then I sizzle. From that cuisine, that's my twist. From my loop to the left, or maybe is it? But go left with the tusk, I'm like the mizzet. Important to the physics, and how they want to dizzet. But be careful, it ain't your ordinary liquid. First time you sip it, you might get addicted. Matter of fact, I know you're born, get addicted. It's so sweet, like liquor, it's good for your sickness. I used to watch my uncle sip it, going through his hat in my grandmother's kitchen. Head in his lap, grandma bitching, pocket full of scratch, scratching and itching. Bing. back when they sit wrong and smoke Tiba. Took daughters for the true Sebas. This one is for my real mud mixers who get screwed up, my thick juice sippers.